Hello friends, very good evening to you all. And first of all, I would ask you for the sorry, a big sorry, because of some unavoidable circumstances, I could not talk and I could not record these all videos of the Hina coaching for you all. So from today, we will be continuing our weekly sessions, and if possible, we will be posting some sessions in between of the scheduled weekly post of Saturday at 7 p.m. So be stay tuned and have a very good enjoyment and learning through the videos. In our today's class, we will be taking an designer Hina of which we call a jewelry pattern as well. So for that, I will be taking a middle flower in the wrist seam. Then here I will be adding an a belt of a checks or the grids, and then I will be continuing them to the finger down with some flowers or some other elements which will be leading towards the jewelry pattern. Okay, so here now I shall say you that do not skip this video, watch it in a full, and still if you have not subscribed our YouTube channel, do it now. So finally here we are starting the designing. Now we are starting with the flower, the base of the flower, and then with the leaves.
A very easy and simple method I'm using here so that you all can actually see it. And enjoy as well. You can put it yourself at home also, and that's not a very difficult part to draw, which leads you to the confidence that yes, you can put this type of jewelries, Hina, on your hand yourself without anyone's help. Now you are old. Again, I'll be taking one slight corner to the downside. Now you know, for the finishing purpose, we need to take this type of four lines and then down the middle to one, instead of taking a dark line directly. And for the strokes, you must have seen all the videos where I have explained all the basic elements. So here basically I will be using a basic checks so that the flower can be highlighted. You can see I'm taking a hand as a supporter downside, for which it will be a more helpful pattern for me to draw. And now I'm putting dots on all the square points. Well, all dots shall come in the same size and in the same manner. So the upside patch is ready. Now we will be turning this patch to the downside, but with turning it down, we will make this flower a bunch of a flower. Instead of taking one flower, we will add some more flowers to this. So first flower I will add downside, and then if possible we will be adding some leaves also. A flower which we have taken here is actually a simple one, but the way we have set all those elements makes this flower more beautiful. A very easy flower with different technique and different settings makes it more memorable. So here I decided that I will be using three leaves only, and to the downside I will be connecting this on the finger, but here I will be using another flower to make it attached. So for the finger of middle finger, I will be connecting this. So here I am gonna use a rose flower. You all are aware of that, how to draw it. See, a very easy and very unique one. Here I will be connecting this with around 3 to 4 lines. And these lines I will be turning with the dots. See, this type of dot making should be done. That makes you a professional artist. That looks like a professional artist. Isn't it beautiful? A simple yet beautiful. Now this flower I will be using with more 2 roses to connect it together and to take that henna down with the middle finger. Scallops to the down and to the up. As I said, it's important to be added again and again. So we are using it. Again, double line, darking. Scallops. And the same checks we will be taking to the down. So that it will be a very easy thing to relate. And now this is like a backhand design, so we are already given a nail this side and putting scallops down. Now in this place I will be drawing a checks. So see, same pattern of the checks we have to continue here with. As we are drawing this on a finger, so the checks size should be little small than the upside one. Today's video might be not that clear because of some unavoidable circumstances again, but yeah, you can understand the theme. What I'm going to tell you is, whatever I'm telling you is, so as I said, this is a backhand henna, so I'm slightly drawing nails over here for you to understand, and I'm connecting other fingers with some designer elements so that people can identify this is a jewelry pattern. Basically what I'm doing here is I'm adding some ring patterns to the fingers. And now it's done. You can see how beautiful this looks. Is it?